Thanks, Sue. I'm speaking tonight in support of MEDACT, which is a medical charity who look to promote peace and security, climate, environment, social, economic justice, and human rights as a kind of four key areas. And I'll be talking about their specific policies in relationship to the city and to public health in particular. One positive note I can start off on is that the MEDACT support the nuclear ban treaty and have a policy of cities signing up to support the nuclear ban treaty. Of those of you who don't know, nuclear weapons have been made illegal, which has been signed up to about 60 or 70 countries across the world, not the UK. But Glasgow has signed up to that treaty. So that is a very positive thing we can say of the city. However, we still home BA systems, TALES, and a number of connections with the armaments industry. So as a MEDACT stands for, stands against militarisation and for peace, we would look to see those businesses that are benefiting from the military industrial complex and war and weaponry shut down and removed from the city. MEDACT also has new briefing notes, and I'll put the full details in the chat, on secure housing, and we're looking to see policies around homelessness, to eradicate homelessness and to secure rents, which is something which I know that there is a rent, living rent, are also kind of developing in the city, and there's a lot of activism going around there. Also, livable incomes for all. So this might not be something within the gift of the city council, but it's something that the politicians and political representatives should be taking forward, with things like perhaps universal basic income pilots and things like that within the city. This links into the fourth area, which is about tax justice. So we know that the council tax system is out of date and not fit for purpose. So we'd look to see that a local income tax being brought in to help fund services in the city. There's also the issue, I've put the link in there for the post-COVID situation. So the report, it's quoting from the report, it talks about the neglect of public health in the UK. And it says, among many other states in Europe, it shows that the UK has been reducing expenditure on public health. The Health Foundation estimates that between 2014 and 2020, public health spending per person fell by 23.5%. So as local authorities have responsibility for promoting public health, we need a closer working relationship with the Health and Social Care Partnership, and we need the same kind of openness around funding and a more democratic approach to the services that are delivered by the Health and Social Care Partnership, as well as just the council. I'm going to surprise everybody by finishing on time and not having to be short, but please read the details of these reports, because it's very useful information. Thank you very much.